Greg Gagne here with Vern Gagne from the Windy City and the Chicago Amphitheater. Here we have a tag team champions of the world reigning for 3 years, the longest held tag team title in AWA history, by Nick Bockwinkel and Ray the Crippler Stevens. And tonight, June 30th, 1973, the Crusher and the Bruiser are going to try to take the titles from Bockwinkel and Stevens in a special match, no disqualification. And Vern, bring us up to date on the war between these four individuals.
Well, you're seeing some real veterans here. With Dick, right now, Dick the Bruiser, the Crusher out there. They were probably at their peak, Greg, at this time. And, of course, Ray and Ray Stevens, Ray the Crippler Stevens and Nick Bockwinkel, I'd say also at their peak. So this is going to be a brawl. This is not the kind of match that Ray the Crippler Stevens and Nick Bockwinkel did not want.
Especially in Chicago, where, Crusher and Bruiser, I mean, they were the favorites of the south side of Chicago, the amphitheater, the stockyards. And I don't think we're going to see a whole lot of scientific wrestling in this match here tonight. The Crusher and the Bruiser are typically brawlers, and especially in Chicago. And now, with the advantage of no disqualification, I'm sure they're going to bend every rule they possibly can to take the titles from Bockwinkel and Stevens.
They were tough, Greg, and both of them, weighing in about 260, 65 pounds, they cover almost two lookalikes out there. Well, he had somewhat of a hold here, but you notice it was a handful of hair along with that hold. And this is the type of match it's going to be. Referees would not allow this kind of a match and this to go on. Well, here's a surfboard by Dick the Bruiser, which is, I can't believe it, but he has got a hold on Ray the Crippler Stevens. And Ray trying to get to his corner for a tag off, but
he might be trying to make a wish there.
He's pulling him over, but I don't know whether Nick will get the tag or not. He may get a fine full of hair. I think Bruiser is teasing Bockwinkel.
You know, this matchup.
Oh, they got.
Scientific thumb to the eyes?
Very scientific. Crusher was great at that one.
He had a lot of cute little moves like that.
Not if you're the receiver. They're not too cute.
No.
Bingo.
Little piggyback ride here. And here comes the boot. Here they go. Now they're starting to open up.
Fist in the face. Delivered by the Crusher. A knee to the stomach. Delivered by the Bruiser.
You know, when you look at the four of them, you know, you think of Chicago, the great history and the sports fans that they are, with the support they give the Chicago Cubs, the White Sox, the Chicago Bears. This is like a matchup in the NFL, the black and blue division. This would be like the Vikings against the Bears, or the Lions and the Packers, or the Packers and the Bears, and how physical those matchups were. And I'm sure how those guys, and you know how you felt after a match with guys like the Crusher and Bruiser and Bockwinkel and Stevens. You wrestled all four of them.
Oh, yes.
You know, what's your opinion? Who of the four, who is the best wrestler? Who is the best brawler?
Well, I think Bockwinkel probably was the best wrestler. And it's a toss-up between the other three to Ray the Crippler Stevens didn't get that name Crippler for nothing. He crippled a lot of people in wrestling. And Bruiser, of course, they didn't hide anything like the Crippler would do, like Ray the Stevens. They just flat out blast you and hope something broke. Your nose, a cut over the eye, a knee. We had a lot of injuries, Greg, as you know. Ooh. In knees. There's a right shot to the throat. Some are, and it does look like it's in the chest, but it does slide up into the Adam's apple also. That one there, that was really a direct, I mean, that would be the disqualification in a non-disqualification match.
Well, when you look back at the rules of wrestling in 1973, a little more rigid and than they are today, in the wide open style that some of the WWF brings to wrestling.
Greg, you could not get any more wild kind of a match than you got right here. I haven't seen any match lately, and this, we're talking about 2001 here, that in this match here, I don't see anything like this anymore.
Well, I'll tell you what, I don't think today's athletes, wrestlers, could stand up to the punishment that guys like the Crusher and the Bruiser and Bockwinkel and Stevens could dish out in the ring.
Well, that goes for a lot of people in, of that era. They were, they trained hard, they wrestled hard, and this is an unusual type match. For the reason that there is no rules that they are enforcing. And it is a no disqualification match, so.
Oh, and here the Bruiser, it looks to me like they're trying to set up Nick Bockwinkel for the famous stomach haul, the stomach claw. They're going to work on that lower abdominum here of Nick Bockwinkel. Let's see if...
It looks like he's going to go for the claw, stomach claw.
Yep.
And there he is, yes. The Bruiser nails Ray the Crippler. And big back body drop. Another great scientific move. But and there they both go with the claw, stomach claw.
And there you have it, your first fall. The Crusher and the Bruiser taking fall number one from Nick Bockwinkel and Ray the Crippler Stevens. Again, 2 out of 3 fall match. No disqualification. And right now in command, Nick the Bruiser and the Crusher. And again, Dan, Nick Bockwinkel and Ray Stevens have held this title for 3 years. So they were veterans. They were good. But right now, I don't know if they can withstand the punishment that the Crusher and Bruiser are dishing out.
Well, yeah, they are really dishing it out. And whether they can stand the pressure or not, we don't know.
Crusher going back for that stomach claw. Bockwinkel making the save. We're going to think of Chicago and, you know, and the crowd that was down there. I can imagine the intensity right now and that whole building vibrating, especially now with Bockwinkel and Stevens starting for the first time in the match, taking over a little bit on the Crusher and the Bruiser. I imagine that crowd is going wild.
Well, the crowd in Chicago, there's about 18,000 people there in the amphitheater, and they turned them away for this one. They must have turned about 5 or 10,000 away wanting to see this match.
And as you know, incidents you've had in the ring with in Chicago, Bockwinkel and Stevens weren't really very favorites of the Chicago area.
You can say.
You remember a match with Nick Bockwinkel one time when some shots were fired out at the two of you.
Yeah, is that right in that very same building at the International Amphitheater. They shot 5 times, missed us in the ring. I know they were shooting at Bobby the Brain Heenan and Nick Bockwinkel. I mean, I didn't know it at the time, but later on we found out. But the person that did the shooting shot 5 shots, hit 2 people at ringside. One very severely, and just got up and walked out and never was caught.
You know, when you talk about Bobby Heenan, where is he tonight?
That's what I'm wondering. I wanted to get that in because...
Well, I just found out. I look back in the history books. Bobby Heenan was barred from ringside for this match by Stanley Blackburn. So a lot of advantage here going for the Crusher and Bruiser. No disqualification, no Bobby Heenan. They've got everything going their way and just kicking the... the heck out of
Bockwinkel. That's what you're saying, right?
Yep.
And here we go. Another shot to the head with a scientific boot by the Crusher.
I think the bottom of the boot read Bockwinkel.
Into the turnbuckle. Now, the turnbuckles are not... If you see that turnbuckle, it's kind of slid down, and right underneath there's a steel bolt holding the rope up there. And that's probably some of the cuts that are from the punches, but also those turnbuckles.
A 2 count there by the Crusher, almost gaining. Oh, here we go. Crusher jumping out after Stevenson. You know what? Stevenson and Bockwinkel were smart. They used the aggression of Bruiser and Crusher, made him make mistakes. Crusher just made one, and now Ray is just pounding his head, not off the turn pad, but off the connecting steel pipe. Connected to the pipe of the ring.
Well, they got him now. They busted him open.
Crusher was a bleeder. You know, once you got cut in professional wrestling, you got that scar tissue built up. It wasn't hard to bust it back open again.
You're right. There's
look
that,
out.
That look.
Here he comes, the Crusher. And when he saw blood or smelled blood, boy, it kind of turned him on. He got cranked up. Oh!
Ran into a fist.
Oh, Ray caught him with a big right on the chin, and it knocked Crusher
that's
down.
Three. That's the second fall.
Yeah, well, that was a 3 count. That would make it the second fall. A fall apiece. Crusher and Bruiser winning fall number one, and now Bockwinkel and Stevens fall number 2. Shortly coming up, fall number 3. Again, no disqualification. We've Crusher now in a weakened position. Busted open on a cut over, it looks like, the right eye. Crusher could withstand a lot, though. I remember he lose a lot of blood in a match, but you say the more blood he saw, sometimes it pumped him up a little bit.
You're absolutely right. They're making a mistake, but wow, he is cut open bad, no doubt about it. Ordinarily, I think they would have stopped this match had it not been a non-disqualification match.
In boxing, you see that quite a bit when they get that cut over the eye and the blood runs into the eye and you can't see, and that's what Crusher's having trouble doing here. There he throws a couple, a good right, another scientific bang the heads together, and here we go.
This is the third fall.
The Bruiser, I don't know, he's trying to make a tag there to Crusher. I don't know what he was pointing at. They've got something in store here for Nick Bockwinkel. But here's that 50 megaton arm.
You see how Stephen just stunned when he got hit. Just
right back on his
heels. Couldn't fall, couldn't do anything, just stand there. Uh-oh.
Some more scientific punches here.
Crusher, Bruiser was setting up something right here at this point. Oh, there. A collision.
You know, Ray, it looks like
two Cadillacs hitting.
It looked like Ray caught his head right under the... It might have been right into the teeth of Nick Bockwinkel, but Ray looks like he split open. Bockwinkel making a save. Let's take a look at Ray here. He looks like he may be cut up also. Unless it's blood from Crusher. No, Ray is busted open also. I thought when they hit heads there, Ray took the brunt of it.
Oh, right. Well, this was a memorable match.
Bockwinkel making the save on that one, trying to get Ray out of the ring and make a tag to him. He may be causing more problems here for Ray Stevens than he is helping. Have you seen any holds? I see a lot of punches.
I've only seen two holds in the whole match, so it's not exactly the most scientific one.
Nice. Those are some vicious right hands by Dick the Bruiser on that cut that was opened up earlier on the collision with Bockwinkel and Stevens.
Here they go, Greg. Yeah, here they go. Bam!
Ooh.
Another one, and bam!
Ray looks like a rag doll. He's out. Here comes Bockwinkel. Now check me.
He grabbed something from his trunks.
Oh,
and
he
jumped
nailed
out,
Bruiser.
Pretty
hit good.
It. Did the hit. Jumped out of the ring.
There's the three count. That was the three count. Your winners are going to be Bockwinkel and Stevens. But I don't think Crusher and Bruiser believe that this thing is over. There it is. Your winners. Ray the Crippler Stevens and Nick Bockwinkel. They retain the AWA Tag Team Championship of the World. And look at Ray Stevens.
I've never been in a match this bloody, I guess you could call it. And
I don't know. I saw some matches with you and Mad Dog Vachon, and you were pretty well bit up and scratched up.
Well, that's right, too. I forgot about that one. And
well, you forget a lot of things.
Well, when you get to be, 46 like I am, you can't
Which
forget.
You're younger than I am.
You've seen one of the biggest brawls that you'll ever see.
But, man,
ring.
This was a very physical, brutal match. And, again, Bockwinkel, look at Ray Stevens.
Well,
holy
Christ.
I mean, that is both him and Crusher took a physical beating in this match, and they're going to feel this for weeks after. Again, your tag team champions retaining the championship, Nick Bockwinkel and Ray the Crippler Stevens, from June 30th, 1973, the Chicago Amphitheater.